Welcome to today's video. In this video, I will show you how we can draw commonly used correlation Pearson and Spearman coefficients. These both coefficients help us to understand how variables are related. Pearson is great for linear relationship in continuous data, while Spearman is ideal for monotonic relationship in any type of data. For this, I will be using a free web tool, SRplot website, in which there is no need of any coding or software installation. You can simply paste values and you can get high quality correlation coefficient plot in a single click. Here is SRplot website. As I have previously told in my videos that this website need login, and it is totally free to register for this website. And when you will register, you will get free 50 points. And if you don't want to register, you can simply use this test account, but it is better if you can register yourself. Here is SRplot website, and you can simply search like Pearson. You can see when I have just wrote P, it is showing Pearson and Spearman scatter plot. So you can simply click on this, and here you can see we have Pearson and Spearman scatter plot available. You can click on this, and this box can be used to input our data. So let me show you that how you can prepare your data and input in this box to get correlation coefficient scatter plot. Here you can see we have actually the two data types. One is normal and one is cancer type cells, and here are the different genes expression. We have 29 genes and we have their expression, and we want to check whether there is any correlation. And we know that Spearman and Pearson correlation coefficient are represented through R, and their value range from +1 to -1. You can also prepare your data types for your variables, and here are two contrasting data sets. So what you need, you just need to simply copy all the data including their headers, and can copy and directly paste into this box. But make sure that you are using point as decimal separator, not as comma in your data. So here you can choose the figure width, figure height, and similarly you can choose P value font size, and similarly tick font size you can control, and axis label font size if you want to change, and which method you want to use. Because we know that in Pearson correlation this line would be linear, and in Spearman correlation this line would be little curve. So you can choose any method whatever you want. So I will choose Pearson in this example, and from here you can choose the points and lines. And from here, whatever you want to use these data points to be represented in circle form, square form, or vertical square form, I will go with the circle. So here is rug. If you want to mention the rug's point, you can also mention, but there is no need to mention the rug at the time being. So you can here select the font family sizes. I will go with Arial. So I will simply click on the submit. It will just take few seconds, and here you can see our correlation coefficient is ready and can be downloaded in the form of PDF, PNG, SVG. So let me download it in the form of PNG. Here you can see it is ready, and we can directly use it in our research article. So hopefully this website will be helpful for analysis of your data. See you in next video. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.